What up, g'day, and welcome back. In this session, I'm going to go through the ideal food pyramid, not just for effective weight loss, but also for a healthier life. I'm going to talk about the importance of moderating your insulin production by limiting your intake of processed carbohydrates. And yes, this even includes whole grains, which will allow you to not only succeed long-term with weight loss, but also potentially prevent many common lifestyle-related health issues. So let's have a look at the human physiology. If you go back to the hunter-gatherer days, we didn't have a constant source of food, and so our bodies became efficient for storing energy to use when food was scarce. Yes, we've evolved since then and have access to ample food. However, physiologically, we're pretty much the same. Our ancestors lived off foods that were easy to hunt, gather, and prepare. Animals, leafy plants, in-season fruits and nuts, and essentially fat and protein and fiber-rich plants. So, and grains and the other high carbohydrates foods were really limited, and as such, our body adapted to using carbohydrates for energy or, if unused, to store as fat. The basis of this program is ketogenic, but not as hard-lined as many keto diets, which super limit your carbohydrate intake and very high in fat content. The food pyramid that we're following is that plants, vegetables, fruits, nuts, seeds, herbs, spices, animal products and proteins, meat, fish and eggs are the main foods along with good fats, which are an important component of it. However, what we're suggesting is that you keep your fats to around 60 to 100 grams per day. The fruits and vegetables represent the main source of your healthy carbohydrates and micronutrients, around 50 to 80 grams per day, and your protein servings around the same, around 50 to 90 grams range, depending on your current weight, calorific intake, and the carbs we want to keep in the fat burning zone, ideally on the lower end of it, for easy and effortless weight loss. So each of these components we'll cover in detail a little later. So what about insulin? It really is all about your insulin response. If you have excess body fat, it is a direct reflection on the amount of insulin that you produce and your ability to moderate insulin production and burn stored body fat for energy. Insulin is really important for transporting nutrients to cells. However, with too many carbohydrates, it gets out of balance, leading to cells becoming insulin resistant. More fat gets stored and is difficult to use as a source to burn. In simple terms, when we produce too much insulin, your liver and muscles are filled with glycogen, so any glucose remaining in the bloodstream that isn't used for energy is converted to triglycerides and sent to fat cells for storage. It then signals the fat cells to hold onto the fat and not use it as an energy source. So then, fat cells can't release their stored energy and fat cells get bigger, leading to weight gain. Okay, next up we're going to discuss what to avoid. So head over there now and we'll see you there.